Hello and welcome to this lesson, brought to you by BitMerge. In this lesson, we'll introduce a powerful data type known as a dictionary, then dive a little deeper into the lists we started talking about in the previous lesson. If you think of a dictionary as storing words and their corresponding definitions, you've almost completely grasped the concept of a Python dictionary. Remember that a list in Python is an indexed collection of items, where Python sets the index as a number starting from zero. Dictionaries allow the programmer to set the index, and that using any data type. Just like Python lists use square brackets and tuples use parentheses, dictionaries have their own way of enclosing items, curly braces. Each item in a dictionary is a combination of the index, called a key, followed by a colon, then the value. If we were to model a dictionary of words, we could do that with a Python dictionary. Let's say the word Python is defined as awesome, and the word programming is defined as fun. Now, instead of finding values in a dictionary using an index number, we can use the key we defined. To find the definition of Python, we use Python as our key, enclosed by square brackets. Just like for lists and tuples, we can find the number of items in a dictionary with the len function. Dictionaries have an additional function, keys, to give us a list of all the keys in our dictionary. You'll see how this is extremely useful in the next lesson when we try to access items in a dictionary, but don't know what the keys are. Now, to go a little deeper with lists, let's create a list of favorite songs, and let's say that if multiple songs from a single artist appear in our list of favorite songs, they are grouped into a sublist. In this list, we have Stressed Out by 21 Pilots and two songs by Adele, Hello and Someone Like You. This is what is called a multi-dimensional list, a list where at least one item is a list itself. To access Stressed Out, we can print fave songs 0, but to access one of Adele's songs is a little trickier. If we print fave songs 1, we get the list that contains Adele's songs. To access this second dimensional list, we add another set of square brackets, so hello can be found by printing fave songs 1, 0. The same concept applies for any number of sublists. Let's return to the concept of mutability from the last lesson. Remember that lists and dictionaries are mutable, that is, the values can be changed at any time, but tuples are immutable. This seems like a simple concept, but there's a bit of a nuance that can cause issues for beginning programmers. Let's first look at a situation where what we expect to happen does happen. Let's make x and y variables and assign them the same integer value. If we print out x and y, we can see that they have the same value. If we change x and then see what x and y are now, the result makes sense. X has its new value and y has its old value. This works a little differently with lists. Let's again create an x and y and assign the same list. If we print out x and y, we can see that they both have the same list as we would expect. If we change one element in x, here's where we have to be careful. Looking at x and y now, we can see that they are the same list, although we only changed x. What's happening here is x equals y for integers makes a copy of the value, but x equals y for list gives the variables the exact same list, which means changing one changes the other. In computer memory terms, this means that the variables x and y point to the same memory address when x and y are lists. Just one thing to look out for. Thanks for plugging in. Your thoughts mean a lot to us. Let us know what you liked, what we missed, and what you'd like to see next, and we'll see you back here soon.